to the guests who are here today. Thank you for joining us to discuss this important ballot proposal, which the Michigan Health and Hospital Association has very, very serious concerns about, which is why I am here today with members of the Defend Michigan Democracy Coalition, who is working to defeat this proposal. As indicated by Mr. Peerage, the coalition believes that this proposal fails to conform with the requirements that are needed for ballot proposals to be considered by the people. We believe it not only to be illegal, but to be a very dangerous proposal as well. If it's passed, the impact on the state's constitution would be significant and something that we believe, as other people have commented, would lead to political gridlock and financial chaos here in the state of Michigan. Community hospitals rely upon state funding to keep the doors open 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year. The state funding is critical to that. Under this proposal, we're fearful that that fragile infrastructure, the healthcare infrastructure that this state has, would be at risk. If it is at risk, then the access to patient care becomes more difficult for the citizens of the state.
I was a lawmaker here for 12 years, and I know firsthand how hard it is to reach compromise in the state capitol. Now, a supermajority rule is really a super minority rule. It would only make it harder, if not impossible, to really advance good tax policy. Just a small minority of 13 senators could block any kind of across-the-aisle compromise. And what this means is that the will of the majority would not prevail. That means 175 years of simple majority rule out the window. Now, states that have this proposal as part of their constitution are not doing well. Now, I love my state. I love the state of Michigan. And I want it like you. I want it to flourish and to prosper. This is a super bad proposal that would really make it impossible for lawmakers to react as needs arise to improve our state. Now, do we want to be like California, where gridlock rules the day and education investments have plummeted? I think not. Do we want to be like Mississippi, the poorest state in the country? Or how about Nevada, with the highest unemployment? All those states have a supermajority rule. Now, we've had majority rule for 175 years in this state. It's really worked pretty well. Let's keep it that way. The supermajority is super bad for Michigan.
My name is David Lawson. I'm the mayor of the city of Linden and also the vice president of the Michigan Municipal League. Here on behalf of communities throughout the state of Michigan, we have Sue Osborne, the mayor of Fenton, Lynn Marklin, the city manager of Fenton, Nathan Triplett from the city of East Lansing, Todd Campbell from the city of Saline, and my good friend Deb Doyle from the city of Durant and a former president of the league. The cities and villages of the state of Michigan make up the fabric of our great state. And in this last decade, statutory revenue sharing payments to our communities have been reduced by nearly $4.2 billion. In the city of Linden, revenue sharing only makes up 16% of our general fund today. This reduction in funds has resulted in postponing important infrastructure projects and eliminating other programs for libraries and recreation. Since the tragic events of 9/11, there are nearly 3,000 fewer police officers on our streets in the state. The passage of this ballot proposal will make it nearly impossible to pass important revenue increases or replacements that fund critical services to our citizens. In an era of a term-limited legislature, it's often difficult to even get the most innocuous legislation passed by just a simple majority.
AARP is concerned with this ballot proposal because of the hand-tying that it will do for legislators to make tough decisions regarding funding vital services for citizens of the state of Michigan. AARP members are concerned about vital community services, for long-term care services, for funding for essential services, and this ballot proposal would tie the hands of legislators who make those very important decisions.
This afternoon, we're going to file a challenge with the State Board of Canvassers in regard to the initiative proposal to amend the Constitution that was submitted earlier this year that would add the so-called supermajority requirement, which in fact is a superminority requirement, to the Michigan Constitution in regard to taxes assessed in the state of Michigan. This is a copy of the petition itself, and at the top of the petition, I've circled the language that actually appeared on the petition that the signers of the petition would have seen. And as you can note from this distance, all it does is talk about the addition of a new Section 26A to Article 9 of the Constitution. Importantly, the Michigan Constitution has rigid requirements with regard to amending the Constitution. And one of those requirements that the legislature has enacted under Article 12, Section 2, is the requirement to publish all of the provisions of the Constitution that would be altered or abrogated by a new proposal. In regard, there are five in this particular proposal, provisions of the Michigan Constitution that should have been printed on this petition or on the back of this petition so that the voters who were asked to sign it would have known that it goes far beyond adding a new subsection to the Michigan Constitution.